Right, here's another one about crossbows. This one's going to be about how they work. I have an example here of a hunting bow from the 14th century, and you'll see that it's got a spring on the top there for holding the quarrel on, and underneath, I don't know how well you can see this, underneath there is a cylinder which turns round and round. It's got hooks on it which hook the string, and if you turn it all the way around, you can see there's a notch on the other end of it, and into that notch fits the top end of this thing. So that goes into the notch, and there we go. And now it's ready. So if I push on that hook now, it doesn't go anywhere. So that will hold the string, and then when I, when the string has it under tension, I pull this lever and round it goes. And you hear it thwacks very loudly up against this. So when these go off, in fact, I'll shoot it in a moment and let you listen to it. When these go off, it's with a bit of a clang. Here you can see a couple of, a couple of bars sticking out. There's actually one continuous pin that goes through. That's for attaching the goat's foot lever. It was a lever that would hook on there. I've got another video which shows how they were used, and that was a device for loading them. And of course, this one has got the stirrup. Your foot goes in that, and that makes it so much easier to pull on the string. Right. Now, shall we, do you want to do it?
No, do it.
Okay. I says I'm a little bit nervous. Oh, come on. There we go. Okay. So, the quarrel goes in there. I won't, because it's dangerous. There are no sights on it, but you could get used to putting this part of the stock against the same part of your cheek every single time, so you'd end up holding it pretty much in the same place. And then, not much recoil, but that was pretty loud, particularly for my ear, it was right next to this. So there you go, a crossbow going twang. This was a nasty weapon. They're sort of ugly and brutish, aren't they? There's something evil about it, and these were actually banned. I mean, you can kill a knight. I mean, a proper knight, a nobleman, a good guy who's gone out to, you know, on crusades or something with one of these, and the Pope banned them. You see, you were not allowed to shoot Christians with these. Obviously, you could shoot non-Christians. I mean, that goes without saying, but Christians, no. You weren't supposed to shoot these. Unless, of course, they were the wrong sort of Christian, in which case it was fine.